Hi, my name's Joanna Flukey. I'm a senior direct representation attorney with Kids in Need of Defense in our Los Angeles office.
Priya Konings, Kids in Need of Defense, Washington, D.C. office.
Kate Pritchard, I'm currently living in South Texas.
Mary McGuire, I also live in South Texas.
My name is Elaine Fordyce. I'm an immigration attorney in Seattle, Washington.
We routinely work with unaccompanied children, most of whom are from El Salvador. We wanted to give ourselves a little more context and educational background on some of the things our clients are going through and try to be able to get a little more perspective and be better informed so we can better advocate for them when we go home.
The vast majority, I would say about 99% of our clients come from Central America. I think that in the U.S., we really grossly oversimplify the reasons why Central Americans, specifically Salvadorans, are fleeing El Salvador. When you come here, you realize that the dynamics that are going on in the country are much more complex than we ever realized.
It's so much different to hear the stories and to see like what the reality is. So when they talk about their house, to see what that might look like and what their town structure might look like and get a better picture of that.
I think that the Salvadoran participants have had so much perspective, especially their understanding of and their participation in the non-governmental organizations.
We hear about organizations doing things in El Salvador, of course, but we didn't have access to them, we didn't know how to contact them, and now
and the seminar, I think, will really help us to serve our clients better by understanding where they're from and kind of what their home is like, and to just give us a deeper sense of the issues that are happening right now in El Salvador. I think it's really important to talk about issues like this so that as attorneys we can be better prepared to make stronger arguments for our clients, and so that we can connect with our clients on a deeper level and understand them more holistically as human beings and not just as statistics that are coming across our desks on a piece of paper.